Hey guys, welcome to Crack Java. In this video, I will explain the Hashmap internal implementation. So let's get started. So Hashmap is very important data structure in Java, and it used in lots of places because it provides very fast retrieval of the information. So complexity to get the information from Hashmap is O of 1. So that is very fast. It's because it calculates the hash code to get the information. So as you see on the screen, it has a table array which has 16 default size. So it stores the information into this table, and it has a hash code integer value, a key value pair, and it has a node which represent a next pointer. So whenever a collision happen into Hashmap, the next this pointer is used to get the address of next node. Okay, so it's a key value pair. Based on the key, we can get the information from the hash map. So when we put any value to the hash map, it first calculate the hash code of that particular object, and after calculating hash code, it perform a bitwise operation on the hash code, and that particular operation will give a less value because the hash code might return a big integer value. So to make it small, it again perform a bitwise operation, and then after that it get the table address and it store the value that particular address. So while putting some, it can happen that two objects have same hash code, then that's a collision, and in that scenario it will create a linked list, and then that linked list will be having the objects. So whenever the second objects have same hash code, it will be provided to the next pointer of the linked list. So but after Java 8, it is actually changed. It's a self-balanced tree, it's not a linked list after Java 8. Okay, so whenever we get the information from the hash map, again it calculate hash code, and if after calculating hash code, it again get the index with the same operation. It perform the bitwise operation on that particular hash code, and it will get the particular index of the array, and it get that particular value. And if there are more than one values on that particular index because of the collision, then it use the equal method to compare the values of the object to get from the linked list. Okay, so to understand this more, let's check the Hashmap class in Java. So this is we have a Hashmap class. Okay, let's check the put method of this class. So this is the put method. When we put any value, it call the put value function. Inside it first calculate the hash code. So here it is performing same operation as we have seen here. So it is calling object.hashcode, and it is using a bitwise operation to get the value. Okay, so after calculating hash code, it called this method putVal method. Here it is using this operation to getting the index of the array, and then it store the value to particular index. Okay, so let's check some example. So let's say we have three objects, v1, v2, v3, and we will put these object into Hashmap, and then we can calculate the hash code as per this algorithm. So this class I have created in my last tutorial. So this is a bucket class which have height and width, and I have overridden equal and hash code. Let's create some object of this class. Let's say we have b1 object equal to new bucket, and so we have a 0 and 31st value. Okay, let's create three objects, v1, b2, v3. Okay, so this should be 10, Okay, and this is 11. Yep, so now we can use the same algorithm to perform to calculate the hash code. Then we can replicate the, we can check the index, which index it is storing and how it is using the bitwise operation to get the particular index. Okay, so let's print this. Let's print the value of hash code. Okay, so this should be int. Okay, so if we see the hash function, this is an integer value. Yep, so here let's remove this. First let's call the b1.hashcode, and here we can use the second algorithm. Okay, so open the put method. Here it is calling this statement to get the index. Okay, so we can print this. Okay, this is h. So first I'm calculating hash code for b1 object, and we can print this. Let's run this. Okay, so when we put the v1 instance into Hashmap, it first calculate the hash code 992. So since 992 is not a small value, so very high value, so that's why again it calculate the index. So it has calculated index as 0, so it will store this value into first index. So b1 will be stored at the 0th position. Okay, so let's check this for b2 as well. Yeah, so b2 has same values, 992 for the hash code, and this is a collision. So because 992 is the same hash code and the index is also same because of the hash code, so this is a collision. Now a linked list will be created at the 0th index, and after Java 8 it will be a self balanced tree, and here b1 and b2 will be stored at the 0th index. Okay, so if we add b3 object, let's check out the result. Yeah, it is different. So for b3, it is the hash code is 1413 and the index is 5, so the object is getting stored at index 5. Okay, so this is how it works, and let's create a map and then let's put the value into map. So let's say we have a bucket map. Hash map. Okay, so this should be string. Okay, the value is string. Now put all the variables. Let's put the b1 first and add some value for the b1, say it is first bucket. Okay, let's add b2 and b3 as well. Second. Okay, so this is second and this one is third. Okay, so now we can print the map entry set, and can use stream dot for each. Okay, we can use system dot out dot println just to print the key and values. So set some print statements. Okay, so key is t dot get key. Okay, so it has a height, so we can print this. And same way, let's print out the width as well. Okay, t dot get key dot width, and let's print the value as well. Okay, here t dot get value, this will print the value. Okay, so let's run this. So as you see, we have three values which are present into map. Okay, so the three values b1, b2, b3 are all three are present into hash map. So these two values have same hash code, but the collision happen into hash map, and the value is stored at the zeroth index. So that's how Hashmap internally works in Java. And we must override equal and hashcode both methods while we use any custom object as a key into Hashmap. Okay, so that's about the internal implementation of Hashmap. In my next video, I will discuss the put and get value in Hashmap when equal and hashcode methods are not overridden. Okay, and put and get value in Hashmap when equal method is overridden but hashcode is not overridden, and put and get value in Hashmap when two objects are equal. And at last we'll discuss put and get value in Hashmap when two objects have same hashcode but they are not equal. Okay, so see you next video. Bye bye.